Hi, I'm Shaun from Pestler. When monitoring a healthcare IT environment, knowing that your systems and interfaces are up is one thing. But what you also want to know is what is the health of entire workflows? For example, you might want to see the health of all the steps involved in your radiology workflow. In this tutorial, we show you how to use the business process sensor of PRTG to monitor all aspects of a radiology workflow. Let's get to it. I'm going to set up the business process sensor for our medical environment. Basically, we want to keep an eye on the radiology workflow as a whole, and that means we want to monitor various aspects of it, such as our PACS, our integration engine, and so on. So I'll show you how we set up a business process sensor, and we do it here. I've created a device called radiology workflow. You could create this on any device, but for our process, for our use, we want to have an overview of everything, so we create it as a separate device. Add sensor, do a search for the business process sensor, and here you can see it there. So let's call it radiology workflow. And the way that it works, as you can see here, you can set up the channels. And essentially what you're going to be setting up as each channel is the items that you want to monitor. So the first channel that we're going to set up here is the RIS. And we search for RIS. And here is the radiology information system that we set up before. We click on that to bring it in here. We also want to keep on our PACS, an eye on our PACS. In our environment, we have, if we have a look here, we have two PACS devices. We have an Orthon C and a PACS Cloud. Let's say we want to monitor both within this PACS channel. So I click on Orthon, and then I do another search, and we put in the cloud. And that allows me to set the same error and warning thresholds for PACS in general, and it will let me know the health of our complete PACS system. Then we want to also keep track of some network elements. We have, for example, a Cisco router in our environment, and there it is there, router Cisco. We click on that to monitor it. We also have a storage device, for example, that we want to keep track of, and that is the SAN. Let's have a look. It's the SAN NetApp. And finally, well, not finally, we've got two more that we want to. We want to take a look at our worklist sensor that we created that's querying our worklist. And let's have a look at what we got. It's this DICOM worklist query here that I already set up. And then we also have an integration engine that we need to monitor with the sensor. So integration engine. Let's see. We're gonna do it on our, let's say, Sofico integration engine. And those are our channels that we want to set up. So let's create it, and then I'll show you how the data is displayed. Let's do a scan now and refresh our view. And you can see now we have an overview of our radiology workflow. At the moment it's green based on the thresholds that we set. If I click on it to go into it, I'll show you the channels that we have available to us. And here we have the global state, which is up. And you can also see the different elements. We have the integration engine. We have our PACS, which is up, the RIS. And then we will have our traditional network stuff. In our case, it's the router. And we have the storage device. So everything involved in that radiology workflow is being monitored by the sensor. And if there's a problem with one step somewhere, our gauge would either be yellow or red, and we would know then we need to drill down and find out exactly which sensor is the problem, and then we would know which device or which area to look at in order to fix it up.
If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@pestler.com, and always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.